People everywhere have fears about 2017. Like for me, I'm scared that Donald Trump's gonna stay in New York and make a lot of traffic.
I'm afraid of turbulence, but to be honest, that's every year.
I am terrified that if I have children, they're not gonna have healthcare and then they're gonna have those little Zika heads.
So today we're gonna be talking to people about
what scares them. What is your biggest fear about 2017?
False information.
Ooh.
People sharing news they haven't researched, propaganda being passed around, people getting false ideas about where this world is going.
Oh goodness, I fear the birds. I'm sorry for interrupting your eloquent thoughts.
I have many fears for 2017.
Okay.
I have a lot of undocumented relatives.
Okay.
And one of my fears is that the new administration will pursue the deportation of those people whom I love.
I had someone tell me that their biggest fear was turbulence today.
That's real. I mean, planes are sometimes scary.
As a conservative, looking at my Facebook is very frustrating because everyone's sharing Huffington Post, BuzzFeed all the time.
So you feel like you're, oh my God, I hate birds.
It doesn't really affect me so much because I'm careful. I look at the ingredients, but with chocolates,
okay.
You see there's a lot of new preservatives like TPHQ, PGPR.
Thank you for breaking it to me.
When we have a president that denies that there's climate change when all the evidence is like in our face, we have to be afraid for the little ones.
Do you agree?
Yes.
He agrees.
Donald Trump.
Why are you so afraid of Donald Trump?
Just because of the things he has said and he has no experience. I think he's just crazy guy.
I know I just met you. Can I please touch your scarf really
please
fast?
Please, go for it.
So we're black.
I know.
I didn't know if the people at home understood. We got some melanin happening. And there are some people who have a vested interest in hoping that I don't know things.
Of course.
And they're like, oh no, a smart black person?
Mm-hmm.
Kill it.
Yo, this is my friend Akilah.
Hey, what's up?
Yes. Podemos hablar en español y no nos entiende ella.
Sí, me encanta su cabello.
De verdad que es muy bonito.
Sí, I knew this was gonna happen.
Yeah.
We're gonna play a game. It's a word association game. We're gonna say some words, and the first thing that comes to your mind, you just tell us what it is.
Women's health.
Reproductive rights.
Yeah.
Oh,
I love that.
Zika.
A virus about which I know very little, but fear very much.
You know what I like about you? When you don't know about something, you don't pretend that you do.
Oh wow, I've been working on that. Thank you for that affirmation.
Taxes.
Ugh.
Alt-right.
White supremacists. Mm. Neo-Nazis.
Russia.
Привет.
Does that mean thank you?
No, that's like hello in Russian.
Oh.
Great. So what did we get out of this today?
There are a lot of fears that I hadn't considered.
I feel like if we put a little bit more human in discussions, I think we would get a lot farther.
I think that's the thing, is the discourse has to get to a point where it is civil but also productive.
Yeah.
The internet has you believe that like it's weak to have those conversations or being politically correct is a problem, but I think polite conversation proved to be fine.